Welcome to the B&D RV pregame show. I'm Merlin Rasmussen. We are here at Altamont High School as it is senior night. The Longhorns have just got finished recognizing their senior basketball players and cheerleaders. They will be hosting the region-leading Tabiona Tigers. The Tigers come into tonight's contest with a record of 6-0. Tonight's pregame coverage is being brought to you by B&D RV. B&D RV supplies the Uinta Basin with the best in RV sales, RV rental, and RV service. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchases. Stop in at 1570 West Highway 40 in Vernal and check out our on-the-lot inventory. As I mentioned, the visiting Tabiona Tigers come into tonight's contest with a record of 6-0 in region play.
They will
finish up region play next Friday when they will travel to Rich. That game will be for first place. The Tigers defeated Rich at home about a month ago, and they will, if they can beat Rich, they will win the region title outright, depending on tonight's outcome. If they win tonight's game, they will be guaranteed at least a tie for first place. The Longhorns come into tonight's game holding on to the fourth place in the region. They will have a record in region play of 1-5. They will play their final game at Manila next week. That'll be on the 26th, next Friday. That game will determine who the fourth place finisher. The Longhorns beat Manila in their earlier game that was played here. So they will travel up to Manila for that game next Friday. So hopefully both of these teams looking at an opportunity to be in the 1A playoffs. The Tigers are actually ranked second in the entire state in the 1A classification. And Coach Lee Gines is the head coach for the Tabiona Tigers. He keys to the game before were to attack the rack, needs to get the ball to the rim. He then said rebound and making shots. The Tigers, this is the third game of the Tigers that I will have broadcast, and they do a good job at doing all three of those. They get to the rim, they do rebound, and they make their shots at a very high percentage. Starters for the Tigers tonight will be Dusty Jones. He's a senior, wears number 24, averaging 16.25 points a game. Dylan Leffler, number 21, also a senior. He averages 12.65 points a game. And Devin Leffler, number 34, he's a senior as well. He was the hero last week as the Tigers defeated Duchesne with just took the lead with only 5 seconds left in the game as Leffler hit a layup. He averages 10 points a game. Justin Clyde, the fourth senior, he wears number one and he averages 4.5 points a game. Starting tonight, the fifth starter will be number four, Brennan Wagner. He is a junior, also averages 4.5 points a game. The sixth man and the hero from last week's game against Duchesne is Bo Bateman. He scored 20 points last week, and he averages 7.7 on the year. For the Longhorns, their keys to the game from Coach Eric Watson is to get back on defense. He says they've been working hard on that. The first game against Tabiona, they were able to get out and run on the Longhorns, so Longhorns want to slow them down and limit them to a few fast break points. Rebounding, also a key. They need to get easy putbacks and also keep Tabiona off the offensive boards. And then the third key to the game for Coach Watson is the Longhorns need to find a way to score. The Longhorns are going to start five of their six seniors tonight. It'll be number 13, Ken Oldroyd. Ken averages 2.5 points a game. And number 35, Corbin Arnold. He's a senior, as I mentioned. There wears number 35. Number two, Brock Harrison will start. He averages 4.1 points a game. And number 11, Kix Nilsson, averaging 7.7 points a game. And the last senior to start will be their leading scorer, number 33, Austin Abbott, averaging 10.5 points a game. These are a good group of seniors. I've had the privilege of coaching four of the five starting seniors in football the past few years. Good kids, good athletes, but even better kids. These are These are great young men, and they have been great examples here at Altamont High School. So we look forward to a good game tonight. As I mentioned, a lot riding on this game for both teams as Altamont tries to keep a hold of the number four spot in the region, and Tabiona tries to clinch at least a share of first place as they will travel to Rich next week in a game that could decide the region championship. We have with Tabiona, we have a team that averages a lot of points. They shoot the ball very well. They have three-point shooters, Dylan Leffler. He's made 53 pointers on the year. Devin Leffler follows him with 32, and then Bo Bateman has 25 three-pointers on the year. So they like to shoot it from outside, and they shoot it at a very good percentage, the Tigers do. Then you have Dusty Jones, their leading scorer. He's only made 14 three-pointers, but he does most of his work in the paint. Has a good, quick first step and is able to get to the basket. So that is the Tabiona Tigers. We are getting ready here as the teams are warming up. Little late start as we had senior night, as I mentioned. So we'll go ahead and take a two-minute break, and then we'll be back.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
These days, we all want more speed, and right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
Are you pushing the limits of riding? Are you ripping down the nastiest trails? Adjusting to the elements, racking up the most miles. The 2016 Ski-Doo Sleds. Are you riding or are you watching? See the 2016 Sleds at skidoo.com.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things, that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care. A genie!
Hey, guys. Got some beer, huh?
Yeah.
Right then. That'll just cost you one cell phone, one MP3 player, video games, television. Oh, and being able to hang out with your buddies here. Anything else?
You're dead.
Good choice.
When kids know the consequences, they're much less likely to drink.
A genie!
Hey, guys. Got some beer, huh?
Yeah.
Right then. That'll just cost you one cell phone, one MP3 player, video games, television. Oh, and being able to hang out with your buddies here. Anything else?
You're dead.
Good choice.
When kids know the consequences, they're much less likely to drink.
All right, we are back here at Altamont High School as the Longhorns will prepare to take on the Tabiona Tigers. We'd like to thank the high school administration and coaching staffs for their coordination in helping make this coverage possible. DVD and Blu-ray copies of tonight's games are available. You can go to the website at vtvchannel6.com or you can call 781-1902 for your copy. The teams are lined up. Not sure if they're going to do the starting lineups or the national anthem first. Looks like the cheerleaders are ready for the anthem. So it looks like we're going to have the national anthem. So we'll go back for another break.
Get out of the cold this winter and come to Affinity Sports Zone, where the fun comes naturally. We have arcade games, the lounge room, and batting and pitching cages. We offer a fully stocked snack bar and a bully-free environment where kids can come and have fun. We do parties in groups, or just bring your friends and come on down. Like Affinity Sports Zone on Facebook and come see us today.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
Given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
All right, welcome back to the B&D RV pregame show. Tonight's RV game, or tonight's pregame coverage is brought to you by B&D RV. B&D RV supplies the Uinta Basin with the best in RV sales, RV rentals, and RV service. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchase. Stop by at 1570 West Highway 40 in Vernal and check out their on-the-lot inventory. We are here for the starting lineups. The Tabiona Tigers have been introduced. They start Jones, Leffler, Clyde, and Bateman. For the Longhorns, they've just introduced number 2, Brock Harrison. Now it is number 11, Kix Nilsson. And number 13 is Ken Oldroyd. It is senior night here at Altamont High School. All five starters are seniors. Number 33, Austin Abbott. And finally, number 35, Corbin Arnold, being introduced for the Longhorns. The Longhorns are coached by head coach Eric Watson. The Tabiona Tigers are coached by head coach Lee Gines. And we are ready to get this region game underway. Each of these teams have one more region game to play after tonight. The Tigers will travel to play Rich, and the Longhorns will travel up to play Manila. So it looks like we're going to have Bateman and Abbott to jump center. Austin with a bit of a height advantage here. And we are ready to go. Arnold will control. He gets it over to Oldroyd for the Longhorns. Now over to Arnold. Arnold works off of a screen from Abbott. And now, that's not Arnold. That's Harrison. Now it's to Arnold. Now he goes over to Oldroyd. Oldroyd working off a Nilsson screen. Now he gets it inside to Abbott. Abbott kicks it out to Arnold. Now back to Harrison. Harrison being guarded there by Leffler. He gets by him and a pass kicked away. No whistle on the kick. Tabiona will take over. They quickly push it down to Bateman. He goes now back to Devin Leffler. Leffler will go to Jones. And Jones will go to Bateman. Now back over to Leffler. Leffler, a little crossover dribble. He gets inside, and the ball goes out of bounds. And they're going to say off of the Longhorns, so it'll stay Tabiona ball. 7:14 left here in the first quarter. We're scoreless. The Tigers set to inbound. Leffler gets it into Clyde. Now goes back to Bateman. Bateman will drive. He's cut off. Puts the shot up anyway. It is good. Bo Bateman with the first points of the game for the Tigers. And it is a 2-0 lead for Tabiona. Oldroyd will now go to Nilsson. Nilsson to Harrison. Harrison will go to the top of the circle to Abbott, who now goes off to the wing to Arnold. Arnold looking inside. Goes to Harrison. Harrison will drive. Pump fake, puts the shot up, and it is good, and he is fouled. So a two-point basket there for Harrison, and he will go to the free throw line. Nice little hesitation move there by Brock. And got the contact, was able to put the shot in, and he will go to the free throw line for one more. Senior shot is up, short off the rim, no good. Rebounded there by Bateman. And he will now go to Jones. Jones kicks it out to Leffler. That is Devin Leffler. Devin fires a three-pointer up. It is short off the rim. Rebound there by Abbott, who will go to Oldroyd. Oldroyd starts to push. Now he will slow it up, get it across the timeline, go to Harrison. Harrison works off the wing. Cut off there by Leffler. Will kick it to Oldroyd. Oldroyd looking inside to Abbott. Abbott double-teamed, and he gets it back out to Oldroyd, who will now go off to Corbin Arnold. Comes back to Ken Oldroyd. Ken at the top of the circle. He will go to Arnold. Arnold works off of an Abbott screen, drives, had Abbott going to the basket, but missed him. Tried to get it to Oldroyd, but Dylan Leffler knocks it out of bounds. So the Longhorns will inbound here on the left side. It'll be Arnold to inbound. There's a kick by Bateman. So Arnold will go ahead and inbound again. 2-2 the score, 5:57 to go here in the first quarter. Inbounded to Harrison. He goes to Nilsson, knocked away by Jones. It'll go out of bounds, stay Altamont ball. Arnold set to inbound again, this time underneath the basket. Gets it into Oldroyd, shot quickly up, just off the rim, no good. Offensive board by Abbott, shot up, no good. Rebound by Jones. Jones is going to push. He goes to Leffler. Leffler on the wing, fires up a three-pointer, short, no good. Offensive rebound by Jones, but he's unable to control. Abbott comes away with the loose ball, goes to Oldroyd. Oldroyd will now be cut off there by Leffler. And he picks up the dribble, gets it to Harrison. Harrison will work off of a screen from Nilsson. Free throw line shot, contact. It's good for Harrison. Not the prettiest shot you've ever seen. A little bit of contact, nothing called, but the shot goes in. Longhorns will take it as they have a 4-2 lead. Jones behind the back dribble, knocked away by Harrison, but it goes right to Leffler. He fires up a three-pointer, no good. Rebound by Jones, goes over to Clyde. Clyde will now go back out to Devin Leffler. Leffler drives to the basket, contact. I'm going to call that foul on Oldroyd. That'll be his first. That'll be the first team foul against the Longhorns. We have a substitution, and it'll be Layton who will be checking in. And we're also going to have a timeout. So we'll take a minute to thank some of our sponsors. L&L Motor, 10 event savings going on now at L&L. Receive up to 9,000 off any new heavy-duty truck on the lot. Biggest inventory of Ford and Ram all under one roof. L&L Motor. We also would like to thank Strata Networks. Right now is the best time to join Strata Networks and get the most reliable coverage in the basin going on at Strata. Get $300 back when you switch to Strata's wireless service. At the same time, customers can buy select smartphones and get a second one absolutely free. Strata Networks. Moon Lake Electric is owned by the people they serve. Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned, providing power to the area since 1938. Find them and like them on Facebook, Moon Lake Electric. Also, Ridgeline Motorsports, they will be sponsoring our halftime show. Ridgeline Motorsports, work hard, play harder. All right, with 4:53 to go in the first quarter, the Longhorns 4, the Tigers 2, and Tabiona will inbound. It's Leffler, he goes into Leffler, and it is good. That is Devin Leffler to Dylan Leffler, and we are tied at 4. That is Layton in for the Longhorns. He will go to Arnold, now out to Harrison. Harrison will drive, goes to Nilsson, but it's stolen away by Jones. Jones with contact, the shot is up, it is good. And there's going to be a foul on Corbin Arnold. So Dusty Jones able to push the ball after the steal. Gets the basket. He will go to the free throw line to shoot one. And a foul on Arnold. That will be his first. Second on the Longhorns. Jones. Shot is up. Short. No good. Rebounded there by Arnold. 6-4. Tigers lead. Layton goes to Harrison. Harrison looking to Nilsson. Nilsson back out to Harrison. Now into Nilsson, knocked away once again by Jones. Nilsson knocks it out of bounds, they're going to say. So contact, but it will be Tabiona ball. Devin Lindsay is going to check in for the Longhorns. He's going to replace Corbin Arnold. Devin a junior. Cody also a junior in for the Longhorns. Now with Kix Nilsson and Austin Abbott and Brock Harrison. This is the normal starting five for the Longhorns. Leffler will go to Leffler, now into Jones. Jones will kick it out to Clyde. His shot is up and good. Justin Clyde with his first basket. So balanced scoring here for the Tigers as they lead 8-4. Inside to Abbott. Abbott turns, has it knocked away. He's able to get it back, gets it out to Lindsay. Now off to Harrison, ends up with it, went off of the hands of Layton. And a pass there by Harrison, knocked away by Jones. He was trying to get it to Nilsson. It gets knocked away once again. Harrison on the floor, now kicks on the floor. And we're going to have a jump ball. The possession will go to Tabiona. So quick hands there by the Tigers as they knock the ball away as the Longhorns tried to work it inside. Harrison tried to get it into Nilsson a couple times. Jones, with quick hands, able to knock it away, ends up in a jump ball, and Tabiona takes possession. Leffler will go to Jones. Jones goes to Dylan Leffler. He now kicks it back out to Devin. And Devin being guarded there by Devin Lindsay. Little zone being played here by the Longhorns. Leffler fires it up, no good. Rebounded by Lindsay. He'll kick it out to Harrison. The Longhorns push, but the Tigers are back. Now go to Lindsay, work to Abbott, top of the arc. He goes off to Harrison, who gets a nice pass inside to Lindsay, and it is up and good for Devin Lindsay. Nice pass from Harrison and a good shot. Nice soft touch by Lindsay. Cuts the lead 6-8, Tigers. That'll be that's Leffler back to Leffler. He will look inside to Clyde. Clyde splits the defenders, and he's going to get fouled. They say it was before the shot. Checking in is going to be Zach Hansen. He will check in. Looks like it was Abbott who they called the foul on. That's first on Austin. Ball is inbounded. Clyde will go to Leffler. Leffler yo-yos that dribble. Now he crosses over, gets to the free throw line, but he's cut off. Goes to Bateman. Back to Leffler. And now to Jones. Jones drives, kicks to Leffler. Three-point shot up short. No good. Offensive rebound there by Clyde. Now Bateman will fire up a three-pointer. It's no good. Zach Hansen able to corral the board. Gets it to Layton. Layton will crossover. He will drive, put up a wild left-handed shot, goes down, then comes back out. Dusty Jones there on the rebound, and he'll go to Bateman. Bateman fires up a three-pointer. It's no good. However, Leffler there with the rebound. Now he goes out to his cousin Devin, and a little crossover, may have been a travel, not called. Goes back to Bateman, then to Leffler, now to Clyde, over to Bateman. Back up top to Leffler. And now over to Bateman. Bateman goes into Clyde, knocked away, stolen by Zach Hansen. Good hands there by Hansen. And now Lindsay, and a timeout there by the Longhorns. So it looks like it's going to be just a 30-second timeout, so we'll stay here. Talk about Ashley Regional Medical Center. They are the home of the Basin's best orthopedic care. If you have broken bones, sprains, or strains, or if you have a knee or hip pain, call our orthopedic specialists. Emergency room care at Ashley Valley has never been better. With a new trauma team in place, the emergency department can now respond with all the personnel and equipment needed in just minutes. You can feel comfortable knowing that you will get the best trauma care at Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional invites you to visit their website, ashleyregional.com. Take advantage of the tools and information you will find there. See a list of all the available physicians and specialists. Get information on the medication you are taking and read about the services offered at Ashley Regional. Visit our website today and like us on Facebook, Ashley Regional Medical Center. All right, we're back. The Longhorns took that timeout, so they'll inbound. It's Cody Layton. He'll bring the ball across. Little pressure, throws it over the head of Devin Lindsay and out of bounds, so it will be Tiger ball. Not what you want coming out of a timeout, a turnover, but that's what happens. 1 minute to go here in the first. Tabiona 8, the Longhorns 6. Jones will drive, little bump, shot up, no good. Lindsay will come away with the rebound. And he quick outlet pass to Abbott. Abbott puts the shot up and it is good. And we are tied at 8. Nice pass from Devin Lindsay and Austin Abbott able to lay it in to tie the score up here with 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Bateman works to Jones. Jones will go over now to Leffler. Back top to Devin Leffler. His three-point shot is up, and it is good. So Devin Leffler finally gets one of those to drop, and it extends the lead to 11-8 for the Tigers. Cody Layton, left-handed dribble. Now crosses over. Hands off to Lindsay. Now goes to Hansen. Hansen will go back to Lindsay. 5 seconds. Layton's going to fire up a long three-pointer. It is good, and we are going to end the first quarter tied 11-11, and we will go back for a break.
These days, we all want more speed, and right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
All right, we are back. An exciting first quarter ends 11-11 as Cody Layton hits a three-pointer as time expires for the Longhorns to match the three-pointer that the Tigers had just hit. So as we start second quarter action, it's the Tigers 11, the Longhorns 11. Layton, little trap here. He gets it to Christensen, who has checked in for the Longhorns, who now goes to Nilsson. Nilsson, he's going to get trapped. He quickly gets to Christensen. Nice little crossover, however, going to be stolen away by Leffler, and then a foul on the Longhorns. It's going to be Christensen. That'll be his first. Made a good move, but just got a little bit ahead of himself, and Leffler was able to steal the ball away from him. So it'll be Tabiona ball. They'll go to Jones on the wing. He goes to Leffler, who works off a screen. Three-pointer, no good. And Arnold comes down with the rebound. We're going to have an over-the-back foul on Bateman. That'll be foul number, I guess that is the first foul against the Tigers. Four against the Longhorns. Wagner will replace Bateman. And that looks like Arnold, he's going to get it into Layton. Tabiona going to do a little half-court trap there. Longhorn's able to break it as it goes off Arnold. Now goes back to Layton. Layton crosses over, now goes to Harrison. Harrison in traffic. He tries to pass it out, stolen away, but Brock's able to steal it back from Jones. Now he goes to Abbott. Abbott will go to Arnold. Arnold goes to Layton. Layton now goes over to Harrison. Three-pointer up, and it is good. Brock Harrison hits a three to give the Longhorns a 14-11 lead for 6:40 to go here in the second quarter. Leffler back to Leffler. Now to Jones. Jones will quickly drive, kick it off to Leffler, who goes to Leffler. Now over to Clyde. His three-pointer up, no good. Rebound there by Arnold. Arnold will go to Layton. Layton guarded there by Dylan Leffler. He goes to Arnold, who's guarded by Jones. Gets it into Abbott. Three free throw line shot up, off the down, and then it comes back out. Good shot there by Austin, just didn't get it to fall. Now Jones will fire up a three-pointer. His goes off and around the rim, no good. Arnold will chase it down. Able to finally control, gets it to Layton, who fires to Nilsson. Nilsson with a quick move, shot up, and it rolls off the rim, no good. Rebound by Wagner. Goes to Leffler, who quickly goes to Jones. Jones will go back to Leffler. Now over to Jones, working on the baseline. He will drive, kicks it out. Open three-pointer by Clyde is up, and it is good. And we're tied at 14. Justin Clyde with the three-point shot for the Tigers. Cody Layton goes to Nilsson. Now goes to Arnold. Working on that right wing. Goes outside to Abbott. His three-pointer up off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound by Leffler. Now to Jones. Jones will drive. Contact shot up. No foul called. And the Longhorns will come away with the loose ball. Arnold back to Layton. Tabiona wanted to travel there right in front of their bench. Didn't get called. Harrison will hold the ball. He will now go to Nilsson. Nilsson fires to Arnold, who goes into Abbott, who goes to kicks. Kicks a shot up, and we're going to have a travel before. Kicks lost control of it as he was going up and came back down before the shot came up. Oldroyd and Lindsay will check in for the Longhorns. They will join Nilsson, Harrison, and Layton on the court. Got Leffler, Jones, Wagner, and Clyde for the Tigers. It is Clyde with a long cross-court pass for Leffler, who fires up a three-pointer just off the back of the rim. Rattles around, offensive board by Wagner. Now to Jones. He goes to Leffler. He'll fire up that three-pointer. Short, no good, but another rebound. Then a block shot. Jones put it up, and he was blocked by Nilsson. However, Clyde has come away with it. He spins, ball knocked away, and Lindsay finally comes away and goes to Oldroyd. Oldroyd spinning, picked up there by Wagner. Lindsay fires up a three-pointer, no good. Offensive rebound by Kicks. It is up and good, and it is a 16-14 lead for the Longhorns. 3:45 to go here in the second quarter. Cross-court pass to Leffler. He loses control as he goes up. Ooh, looked like he lost control and it went out of bounds. They're going to say off of the Longhorns, so it'll be Tabiona ball. They'll inbound under their basket. Austin Abbott checks in for the Longhorns. Leffler looks, goes to Wagner. He loses control. Now we're going to have a foul. A little bit of a late whistle there. See who they called that on. Looks like they called it on Abbott. That'll be two on Austin. So, and that'll put Wagner at the line to shoot free throws. Wagner's first is up and good. Kicks, Nilsson will check right back in for Abbott. And Christensen will come in for Harrison. Wagner will look to tie the score here. As Altamont leads 16-15. His second free throw is up and good. So we are deadlocked at 16 with 3:30 to go in the second quarter. Lindsay cross court to Oldroyd. Skip pass down to Christensen. He then goes nicely inside to Nilsson, who shot no good. It was down, came out. Stolen there by Oldroyd on a long pass by the Tigers. Oldroyd goes with a nice pass to Layton, who kicks it back out. Lindsay will drive at the free throw line. His shot is up, no good. Fight for the offensive rebound, and Jones able to finally pull it away for the Tigers. 3 minutes to go. We're deadlocked at 16. Leffler looks over to Coach Giles, gets the call. He will drive, gets it inside to Jones, and he will get fouled. Jones will be at the free throw line. It's 0 for 1 tonight from the free throw line. And this is, again, so Dusty, 0 for 2. Tabiona, usually a pretty good free throw shooting team. Jones has missed his first two free throws tonight. He will have another. And this one is good. That'll give Tabiona a 1-point lead with 2:48 to go here in the first half. Layton will get it across. He will go to Oldroyd. He will now go to Christensen. His shot is up and short, no good. Offensive rebound there by Kicks, and then we're going to have a travel. As Kicks tried to jump and then pass, but he came down before. So a turnover on the Longhorns. Bateman will check in for Clyde for the Tigers. They will go to Bateman. Now off the Leffler. He'll go to Dylan Leffler. Drives, shot up, and good. As Dylan Leffler gets his second basket, and will extend the Tabiona lead to 3 as the Longhorns bring it across. Lindsay goes to Nilsson. Now back to Lindsay. He looks to the spinning Christensen. His shot up, knocked away, no good. Rebounded there by Bateman, who quickly goes to Leffler. Leffler goes cross court to his cousin, and Devin Leffler fires up a three-pointer, and it is good. And a quick timeout here by the Longhorns, and it'll be a full timeout. So we'll go back, take a break for 1 minute.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
That three-pointer by Devin Leffler has increased the lead to 6. That is the biggest lead of the night for the Tigers as they lead 22-16. Northeastern Counseling has been providing mental health and substance abuse services to the citizens of the Uinta Basin since the mid-1980s. Northeastern Counseling, a proud sponsor of tonight's high school basketball action. Full court pressure being put on by the Tigers. The Longhorns will get it across. Layton will have it knocked away by Dylan Leffler, and he goes to Jones. Jones has his shot partially blocked by Oldroyd and rebounded there by Devin Lindsay. Be back to Layton. Layton will go to Oldroyd. Now hands off to Lindsay. Back to Layton. Fires up the three-pointer. Long, no good. Back to long rebound by Oldroyd. Similar spot from where Layton hit that to end the first quarter, but this one was long. However, the Longhorns come away with the offensive board. Lindsay with a nice pass to Harrison, who's unable to handle it. He does chase it down in the corner, and we're going to end up with a jump ball, and it'll be Tabiona possession. So Tabiona with a 6-point lead with 50 seconds to go here in the first half, and they will have the ball. It's going to be Devin Leffler who will bring it across the line. 2-3 zone being played here by the Longhorns. Leffler will go to Bateman. Now back to Leffler. 34 seconds. Leffler fires up the three-pointer, rolls off. No good. Oldroyd with the defensive rebound. He will go to Harrison. Harrison gets it into Nilsson. Nilsson steps back and hits that shot off the glass. So 4 points for kicks Nilsson. We'll cut it to a 4-point lead for the Tigers. 10 seconds to go here in the first half. Leffler will now go to Bateman. Bateman traveled, but he wasn't called. Goes to Leffler cross court. Leffler fires up a three-pointer. It is no good. So at halftime, it is Altamont 18, the Tigers 22, and we will be back in just a few minutes for the Ridgeline Motorsport Sports halftime show after a 2-minute break.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
Are you pushing the limits of riding? Are you ripping down the nastiest trails? Adjusting to the elements, racking up the most miles? The 2016 Ski-Doo Sleds. Are you riding or are you watching? See the 2016 Sleds at skidoo.com.
watching the Ridgeline Motorsports Halftime Report
on VTV6.
Welcome to the Ridgeline Motorsports Halftime Show. Halftime Show is brought to you by Ridgeline Motorsports. Ridgeline has a significant rebates going on all 2014, 2015 Ski-Doo snowmobiles and 2015 Can-Am side-by-side and four-wheelers with rebates up to $2,500. Come check out all the new Can-Am Workhorse Extreme Utility Defender with a towing capacity of 2,000 pounds and a payload capacity of 1,500 pounds. A new Versa Pro three-person bench seat with adjustable driver's seat. Every Can-Am ATV and side-by-side vehicle is built with the same DNA, industry-leading performance, precision-engineered handling, and rider-focused design. Get ready to ride with a new Can-Am off-road vehicle at Ridgeline Motorsports. Today, Can-Am, the ride says it all. Go see the friendly staff at Ridgeline Motorsports at 543 East Main in Vernal, or call 789-RIDE. Ridgeline Motorsports. Work hard, play harder. All right. Our score at halftime is Tabiona 22, the Longhorns 18. The Tigers, they are led by Devin Leffler. He scored 6 points. Justin Clyde has 5. Dylan Leffler has 4. Dusty Jones has 3, and then Bo Bateman has a two-point basket, and Brennan Wagner has a couple of free throws for the Tigers, and they lead 22-18. Leading scorer for the Longhorns with 7 points is Brock Harrison. He has a three-pointer and then two two-point buckets. Kix Nilsson has 4 points. Cody Layton has a three-pointer, and then Austin Abbott and Devin Lindsay each have baskets for the 18 points that the Longhorns have. So the coaches had keys to the game. Let's see how they did in the first half. Tabiona wanted to attack the rack and rebound and then make shots. They have not made shots like they've done in the previous games that I've seen. They've had some looks, but they haven't had those shots fall. They have done a nice job of rebounding, especially on the offensive end, and they've done a good job. Jones especially has done a good job of getting to the basket. So the Longhorns, on the other hand, they wanted to get back on defense and stop some of those transition points, and they've done a nice job of that. Tabiona has not had many transition opportunities. They've tried to push it, but the Longhorns have done a nice job getting back on defense. And rebounding, Coach Watson knew he needed to keep Tabiona off the offensive boards, and that has been an area that Tabiona has been able to get some second chance looks. So the Longhorns will need to work on that here in the second half if they want to stay in this game, as they trail by 4, and then find a way to score. And they've done a good job so far finding a way to score and keeping Tabiona from scoring. Tabiona off their regular season average, as they score a lot more than right now. They put them at 44 points. They're up around 60-some points a game. So the Longhorns have done a nice job of keeping Tabiona in check here as they trail just by 4, 22-18. So we'll see what the second half brings. Looks like we had a little bit of an extended halftime here tonight because they did some drawings and different things at halftime. So we'll go ahead and go back for a little bit of a extended break. Thank our sponsors.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
We
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo, and they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
A genie!
Hey, guys. Got some beer, huh?
Yeah.
Right then. That'll just cost you one cell phone, one MP3 player, video games, television. Oh, and being able to hang out with your buddies here. Anything else?
You're dead.
Good choice.
When kids know the consequences, they're much less likely to drink.
Get out of the cold this winter and come to Affinity Sports Zone, where the fun comes naturally. We have arcade games, the lounge room, and batting and pitching cages. We offer a fully stocked snack bar and a bully-free environment where kids can come and have fun. We do parties in groups, or just bring your friends and come on down. Like Affinity Sports Zone on Facebook and come see us today.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high quality service to their customers now and in the future.
Service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
These days, we all want more speed. And right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
are you pushing the limits of riding? Are you ripping down the nastiest trails? Adjusting to the elements? Racking up the most miles? The 2016 Ski-Doo Sleds. Are you riding? See the 2016 sleds at skidoo.com.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
Get out of the cold this winter and come to Affinity Sports Zone, where the fun comes naturally. We have arcade games, the lounge room, and batting and pitching cages. We offer a fully stocked snack bar and a fully free environment where kids can come and have fun. We do parties in groups, or just bring your friends and come on down. Like Affinity Sports Zone on Facebook and come see us today.
Hey, guys. Got some beer, huh?
Yeah.
Right then. That'll just cost you one cell phone, one MP3 player, video games, television. Oh, and being able to hang out with your buddies here. Anything else?
You're dead.
Good choice.
When kids know the consequences, they're much less likely to drink.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services, including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
All right, we're back, getting ready for second half action. Tabiona 22, the homestanding Longhorns 18. With the merger of Pilot Logistics and Thomas Petroleum, customers can now get both Chevron and Conoco oil and lube products. Race fuel and cylinder propane refills are available at the Naples location. Pilot Thomas Logistics continues to offer local services such as fuel and lubes, delivery just as they did for years as Western Petroleum. We'd like to thank all of our sponsors for bringing you high school basketball. The second half, just getting ready to get going here. The Longhorns looks like they will be inbounding. And And it's going to be Lindsay who will inbound to Oldroyd. Oldroyd will work off of a screen. He will drive to the basket, now passes to Nilsson. Nilsson's going to be tied up there, and a jump ball will give the ball back to the Tigers. They'll inbound quickly to Leffler. He'll get it across. Now go to Jones. Jones will work to Bateman. Bateman will drive and puts a shot up. Contact, no foul called. Shot no good. Rebound there by Kix. Kix will go to back to Layton. Layton gets it into Abbott. Abbott drives, puts a shot up. No good. Leffler will come away with the rebound. He will go off to Jones. Jones will go off to Clyde. Nice pass there from Dusty Jones to Clyde. And quick timeout here going to be taken by Tabiona. Coach Gines not happy talking to the official. Affinity Sports Zone is open 7 days a week from 10 to 10, Monday through Saturday, and 10 to 8 on Sunday. They have a large party room, three baseball cages, one soft and one fast pitch softball cage. They also have a pitching cage with a radar. Don't let the cold keep you inside. Come on out to Affinity Sports Zones. B&D RV Center. Tonight's pregame coverage was brought to you by B&D RV. Whether you're looking for your first or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchase. Stop by at 1570 West Highway 40 and check out our on-the-lot inventory. B&D RV Center. All right, so there's a inbounds pass knocked away as Oldroyd's able to control. He will now go to Abbott. Abbott puts a shot up, but he's going to be fouled. So Austin will be going to the free throw line. Foul on Devin Leffler. It's only the second foul against the Tigers as Abbott's first shot is up and good. Not many fouls called on either team, only five against the Longhorns in the first half. And Abbott's second shot is good as well. So the Longhorns cut the end of that lead as they trail 20 to 24. Leffler has it poked away by Layton. Layton comes away with the steal. He will now go to Nilsson. Nilsson one hop, and the shot is up and good. Kix. Nilsson cuts the lead to two. Nice defense there by Cody Layton. Jones will go to Leffler. Leffler back to Leffler. Crossover. He's cut off, and now he goes up with the left hand off the rim. No good offensive rebound, however. Jones' shot's going to be blocked out of there by Kix Nilsson. And so Tabiona will be inbounding. It's going to be Leffler. That's Devin. He will look to inbounds. And he'll get it into Clyde. Nice inbound play. And an easy layup there for Justin Clyde. Brings the lead back to four for the Tigers. Layton goes off to Harrison. Harrison will now go to, he's going to go down to Oldroyd. And Oldroyd will look to get it into Abbott. Abbott being guarded there by Clyde. Turnaround jump shot, air ball by Abbott. And we're going to have a foul on the rebound. That'll go against Kix Nilsson. That'll be his first. Looks like Corbin Arnold and Devin Lindsay are going to check in for the Longhorns. They'll replace Oldroyd and Harrison. Jones will pass it into Leffler. Leffler will work to Leffler. Fires up a three-pointer down, but no good. Comes out. Lindsay with the rebound. Dylan Leffler had a good look at that one. Now Devin Lindsay goes to Layton, goes into Abbott, double team, knocked away. Jones comes away with it, goes to Leffler, but it's stolen away. Now the Longhorns with a shot up, no good. Rebound there by Lindsay, his shot no good. And Clyde will end up coming away with the rebound. Now he'll go to Jones. Jones drives, puts a shot up. Longhorns wanted to travel, but the shot is no good. Layton comes away with it. He'll go off to Lindsay, fires up a three-pointer, just short, no good. Leffler with the rebound, and he'll look to push for the Tigers. Left-handed dribble. He drives into Abbott, and they're going to call the foul on Abbott. Looks like Austin had good position initially, then he reached, got the foul. That'll be his third, and that'll put Leffler at the line. Dylan Leffler, he hasn't first time to the free throw line tonight. Normally a pretty good shooter, and his first one is nothing but net. Extends the lead to five. Nilsson is going to be replaced by Harrison. Leffler will shoot one more. It is up and it is good. Lead back to six for the Tigers. A little bit of pressure being applied. The Longhorns are able to break it, get it across. It's Lindsay. He'll go to Layton. Now to Lindsay's three-pointer up and off the back of the iron, no good. And Jones with the rebound. Jones will go to Bateman. Bateman drives, he's gonna be cut off there, knocked away, picked up by Clyde. Clyde has it knocked out by Arnold. And it'll stay Tiger ball. Clyde will get it into Leffler. Now to Clyde, cross court to Bateman, back to Leffler. He'll fire up a three-pointer. It is off the iron, no good. Rebound by Arnold. And the Longhorns, as Arnold gets it to Layton. Now goes to Lindsay. And Devin goes to Harrison. Harrison able to get it back to Layton. Longhorns will set their offense as Layton go to Lindsay. Lindsay cut off there by Leffler. Now goes to Arnold. Arnold has it stolen away by Dylan Leffler. He will drive to the basket and lay it in. And that'll extend the lead to 8, 30 to 22. 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Arnold shot up. No good. Rebound there by Jones. Jones will look to push. Now goes back to Devin Leffler. He'll go to Dylan Leffler. He'll now go to Jones. Jones kicks it out to Bateman. Three-point shot up, and it is good for Bo Bateman. Bateman coming off a big 20-point game the other night. We're going to have a timeout. It's going to be taken by the Longhorns. Utah State University is a proud sponsor of high school basketball here on VTV Channel 6. Start or complete your education right here in the Uinta Basin and be an Aggie in your hometown. Programs are available in business, nursing, education, natural resources, and many more. Apply now for the best scholarship opportunities and course selection. Visit unibasinusu.edu for details. JCS Construction is proud to support VTV's coverage of local high school basketball. JCS Construction. So after that timeout by the Longhorns, they'll come back on the court and inbound as they trail by 11. The Tigers have extended their four-point lead at halftime to 11 here with 3:25 to go in the third quarter. Layton will get it to Oldroyd. Now cross court to Lindsay. Lindsay will drive, kick it off to Harrison. Shot short, no good. Rebound by Clyde. Clyde will go to Leffler, who quickly goes to Bateman, back to Jones. Jones travels, and it'll be a turnover for the Tigers. Harrison will inbound, goes to Layton. Layton bounces over to Oldroyd. Oldroyd, left-handed dribble, goes to Lindsay. Lindsay works off of a screen. Has it knocked away, but he's able to control, get a shot up. No good, air ball. Tigers will inbound. 2:52 to go here in the third quarter. Coach Gines gives the play call to Leffler. Now goes to Dylan Leffler. Works it to Jones. Back to Devin Leffler. Left-handed layup attempt, no good. Rebounded by Cody Layton. And Cody quickly goes to Harrison. Harrison will drive and put up a shot, no good. fight for the offensive rebound. That was Nilsson. His shot was blocked by Clyde. However, Oldroyd able to come away with it. Goes to Nilsson. His shot no good. Offensive rebound. He will put the shot up, and he is going to be fouled. So he will go to the free throw line and shoot some free throws. Foul is going to be called on Bateman. Three total fouls on the Tigers on the night, two of them by Bateman. That'll put Nilsson at the line. 6 points on the night, four kicks. His first trip to the free throw line. And his shot is up and good. Parker Rust will check in for the first time tonight. He will replace Cody Layton. Parker, just a sophomore for the Longhorns. Kicks with one more. Up and good for Kicks Nilsson. Cut the lead to nine. A little pressure as Parker will pick Leffler up. Leffler able to get by him. And we're going to have a turnover as Leffler called for the carry. So it'll be a turnover on the Tigers. Be Longhorn ball. Rust will go to Lindsay. Lindsay tries to get it into Nilsson. Jones with quick, active hands. Knocks it away. Now Lindsay's pass is over the head of the cutting Nilsson, picked up by Leffler. Leffler will drive, runs over Parker Rust, and it's going to be an offensive foul on Leffler. Be his first. So nice job there by Parker holding his ground. Draws the charge. Under 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Longhorns trail by nine. They have the ball. Devin Lindsay has it poked away, but it goes to Nilsson. Nilsson's shot up is good. Leffler quickly goes to Leffler. Now back to Leffler. Three-pointer up. Off the rim, no good. Tipped away there as Harrison tipped it to Lindsay. And the Longhorns cut the lead to seven. Parker Rust there goes to Lindsay. Now inside to Harrison. Harrison has it poked away, and we're going to have a jump ball. It will stay with the Longhorns. Christensen, also a sophomore, he will check in for the Longhorns. He'll replace the junior, Devin Lindsay. Parker Rust inbound for the Longhorns. Goes way out to Oldroyd, who now goes into Kicks. Kicks turnaround shot off the backboard, no good. Rebound by Leffler. Ooh, double dribble. Didn't get called. He goes to Devin. And Devin will now look to Dillon, who goes to Dusty Jones. Jones will drive. That's going to be an offensive foul as he put his shoulder down into Christensen. Christensen held his ground. So consecutive offensive fouls against the Tigers. And we got a substitution coming in. That'll be Cody Layton. He's going to replace Ken Oldroyd. Cody a junior, Ken a senior. Senior night here at Altamont High. 52 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Tabiona 33, the Longhorns 26. Layton going to work off of a Harrison screen. Now goes to Rust. Rust to go to Christensen. Christensen gets trapped. Nice pass outside to Nilsson. Nilsson's shot, no good. Rebound by Dillon Leffler. He will go to Justin Clyde. Now back to Leffler. Three-pointer up, and it is good for Leffler. It's a guy you don't want to leave open. And he does makes the Longhorns pay as it is now a 10-point lead here for the Tigers. Rust will go to Christensen. Has it knocked away, however. But goes to Layton. We're under 10 seconds to go here in the quarter. Layton goes to Rust. Rust will fire up a three-pointer. It's no good. However, Kicks Nilsson's there for the rebound. But his shot is blocked away by Justin Clyde. So at the end of three, it is Tabiona 36, the homestanding Longhorns 26. We will be back after this short break.
At Boone Lake Electric, we are locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry.
We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
All right, we're back for fourth quarter action. Tabiona 36, the Longhorns 26. The Longhorns, looks like it'll actually be the Tigers' ball, as it'll be Bateman to inbound for the Tigers. Tabiona first in region with a 6-0 record. The Longhorns 1-5. They're currently in fourth place. Big games next week for both of these teams. Leffler goes to Bateman. Long three-pointer off the rim. No good. Offensive rebound there by Dylan Leffler. Now his shot is up and good. Leffler's got a nice shot, as good form. That is Layton who goes to Harrison. Harrison will drive, spin, pumps, now puts a shot up. He's going to be fouled. Contact. It's going to be on one of the Lefflers, so we'll see which one. It's going to be on Devin, number 34. That's his second. That'll put Brock Harrison at the line. Brock is 0 for 1 from the free throw line tonight. His shot is up, no good. It's 0 for 2 for Brock. Austin Abbott will replace Christensen. Harrison will shoot one more. Longhorns trail by 12. That one is also no good. However, we got a whistle here. I think they're going to get Abbott for his fourth foul. Austin just barely checked in. Picks up his fourth there on the rebound. And that'll turn it over to the Tigers. Pass inside to Wagner. Now he kicks it out to Clyde. Clyde will go across court to Leffler. And his three-point shot is up. No good. Clyde with an offensive rebound. And looks like Abbott. We'll see. It's either going to be on Abbott or Rust. They're going to call it on Parker. It's going to be 23 versus 43 or 33. So that'll be the first one on Parker. Now Bateman will drive. His shot is up and good. Bo Bateman extends the lead to 14 for the Tigers. We're at 7 minutes to go in the game. Parker Rust goes to Harrison. He will work off of an Abbott screen. Harrison shot up, no good. Pulled out of the air by Clyde. He now goes to Bateman. Bateman will get it to Clyde. He'll try a three-pointer, and it is long, no good. Rebound there by Abbott. He'll go off to Layton. Layton will cross over. Pass into Nilsson. Kicks away. Nilsson's able to chase it down. He'll go back out to Parker. Parker will go to Austin. Austin over to Brock. He looks for kicks. He has him. Now goes to Cody Layton. Inside to Brock Harrison. Brock will pump fake, and he's going to be fouled. That'll be Bateman. That'll be three on Bateman. Going to be team foul number six. So the next one on the Tigers, and the Longhorns will be shooting 1-1, but this one they will inbound. Devin Leffler replaced there by Wagner. Inside or inbound to Abbott. His shot is up, no good. Nilsson with the offensive rebound. His shot, however, is blocked out of bounds. It'll stay Longhorn ball. So we have 6 minutes to go. Brock Harrison set to inbound. He'll go cross court to Lindsay, and his shot is up, no good. Rebound long there for Jones. Jones will drive, lay it up with his left hand. And it is good for Dusty Jones. Dusty averages 16. That is only his fifth point of the night for the Tigers' leading scorer. Kicks, works it inside, now goes out to Harrison. Harrison with the left-handed dribble goes back out to Lindsay. Lindsay goes to Layton. Layton looking for Abbott inside. Now he's going to work off of, well, Abbott set the screen. Now he'll kick it back to Abbott. Abbott will fire a shot up, and it is good. Austin Abbott will get his sixth point of the game. Leffler will go into Jones. Jones will spin. Left-handed shot up once again. Rebound by Abbott. He'll go off to Layton. Now to Lindsay. Lindsay will drive. Nice pass to Nilsson. And it is up and good for Kicks Nilsson. That was a good pass there by Devin Lindsay. Leffler will go to Bateman. Now over to Jones. Swinging it to Clyde. Clyde will drive. Gets inside the key. Goes to Wagner. Back out to Clyde. Now to Bateman. He'll go to Jones. Jones will work to Leffler. And Bateman's shot is up, no good. Three-pointer rebounded offensively by Jones. His shot is up, no good. Another offensive rebound. That was by Wagner. This is by Jones. We're going to have a foul. Nope, they're not going to say a foul. They're just going to say knocked it out of bounds. Kicks Nilsson knocked it out of bounds. So three offensive rebounds there by the Tigers. And we're going to have a timeout here by the Longhorns. We'll go ahead and send it back for a break.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
All right, we're back. 4:35 to go in the fourth quarter. Tabiona 42, the Longhorns 30. Tabiona will be inbounding.
Bring out your Longhorns, let's go!
It's gonna be Justin Clyde to inbound for the Tigers. He looks, goes to Devin Leffler, now back into Clyde. Clyde will spin, contact, shot up, and it is good for Justin Clyde. 11 points for Clyde. Long pass to Abbott. And he's gonna get fouled. It'll be on Clyde. It'll be his first. Abbott will go to the line and be shooting two. Austin is 2 for 2 from the line so far tonight. Biggest lead of the night for the Tigers, 14 points. Austin Abbott, the Longhorn senior, fires up the free throw and no good. He'll have one more. Arnold, Layton, Abbott, Lindsay, and Nilsson on the court for the Longhorns as that free throw is good for Abbott. Jones, Leffler, Clyde, and Bateman on the court for the Tigers. Leffler's shot blocked away, and finally Kicks is able to control for the Longhorns. And pressure there by Leffler. Layton able to get by him. He now drives, and we're going to have another foul called. So Cody will go to the line to shoot a couple. They called that on Wagner, I think. Yep, that's Brennan Wagner, his first. Cody's first free throw is up and good. He will have one more. And it's up and good as well. So 2 for 2 for Layton. He has 5 points on the night. Cuts it to an 11-point lead. Leffler behind the back dribble. Now he crosses over. He will get to the basket, put the right-handed layup up. It is good, and he is going to be fouled. Nice quickness there by Devin Leffler. He will go to the line, try for a three-point play the old-fashioned way. He has 2 3-point baskets from long range already tonight. So he will step up and rattle the free throw home. So 9 points on the night for Devin Leffler. And the Tigers increase their lead back to 14. Lindsay goes into Nilsson. Nilsson goes to Abbott. Abbott back to Nilsson, kicked away. And now Lindsay will come away with the ball. He'll go to Arnold. Back to Devin. That's Devin Lindsay. Goes to Layton. Three-pointer up, and it is long. No good. Rebound there by, that's Jones and Clyde. And both Tigers fighting for it. That's going to be a travel. So Wagner will come out, and Dylan Leffler will replace him. It'll be Longhorn ball. Corbin Arnold set to inbound. Goes to Lindsay. Lindsay's quick shot is up. Long, no good. Rebounded there by Clyde. Clyde will go to Devin Leffler. He now goes over to Dylan Leffler. Wide open, no good on that three-pointer. He was too open, apparently. However, Bateman able to get the rebound. Let's see. Looks like they're going to call a timeout. So a timeout on Tabiona. We'll go ahead and take a break as well.
These days, we all want more speed. And right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
Are you pushing the limits of riding? Are you ripping down the nastiest trails? Adjusting to the elements? Racking up the most miles? The 2016 Ski-Doo Sleds. Are you riding or are you watching? See the 2016 Sleds at skidoo.com.
Leffler has it knocked away, picked up by Harrison. And now goes to Lindsay. Lindsay goes to a wide open Nilsson, and he tries to pass to Abbott. The ball at Abbott's feet and kicked out of bounds, so it'll be a turnover for the Longhorns. Looked like Nilsson had a shot at a layup. Leffler will drive, little head fake, puts a shot up, and it is good for Devin Leffler. 16-point lead now for the Tigers as we're at 2:38. Remaining in the game. Stolen away by Devin Leffler. And now he'll go to Jones. Jones with the left hand. It is up and good. Just what the Longhorns didn't want to have happen was Tabiona be able to get out and run. And they've been able to do that a little bit more here in the second half. Able to increase that lead. It is now 51-33. Nilsson with the shot up. It is no good. All black jerseys there for the Tigers on the rebound. It was Leffler. He'll go to his cousin Dylan Leffler, and now go to Jones. Jones puts that left-handed shot up again, and it is good. Dusty Jones able to use that left hand inside. Layton goes to, that was, he passed it to Lindsay, but we're going to have a foul first. Cody Layton will be at the line to shoot. Call it on Dylan Leffler. That'll be his second. So Cody Layton will stand in to shoot. Cody's two for two from the free throw line. He was just there a minute or so ago. Hit them both, and the one-and-one shot is up and good for Cody Layton. So he'll have one more. We're under 2 minutes. A 19-point lead for the Tigers. And it is good. Tabiona is taking control here in the second half as it was a close game at halftime. Leffler will bring it across the timeline for the Tigers. He'll go to Jones. Jones now to Dylan Leffler. Back to Devin Leffler. Guarded there by Arnold. He'll now go to Dusty Jones. He'll go back to Dylan Leffler. Back to Dusty Jones. 1:23 to go here in the game. Tabiona in a little motion here. Leffler will kick it out to Clyde. Now ends up in the hands of Bateman, and Bateman's going to be fouled. That'll be the second foul on Oldroyd. That'll only be team foul number 5 on the Longhorns. Brennan Wagner will check in for the Tigers. He's going to replace Bateman. And replace Bo Bateman, so it'll be Devin Leffler to inbound. He'll get it into Jones. Jones is going to be fouled by Kix Nilsson. It'll be 2-1 Kix, and that will be foul number 7. And I misspoke when I said it was only 5 last time. It was 6, so this will be 7. So Jones will go to the line, shoot 1-1. Dusty's 1 of 3 from the free throw line tonight. And make that 2 of 4 as he hits the first. He'll have one more. Brock Harrison is going to come in for the Longhorns. He'll replace Parker Rust. We've got wholesale substitutions for the Tigers. We have number 3, that's Jackson Fabrizio. He's a junior. 23 is Mason Hamilton, a junior. 32 is Cameron Leffler, a junior. Number 10 is Daniel Ludwig, a junior. And number 5 is Hunter Peterson, a sophomore, checking in for the Tigers. So all new troops here for the last 1:09 for the Tabiona Tigers. The Longhorns will go with Abbott, Oldroyd, Arnold. Number 15 is Pass. It's Chris Pass and also Brock Harrison. So we've got 5 seniors out there for the Longhorns here on senior night as they will play out the last minute. Corbin Arnold will be at the free throw line as that foul is going to be called on Cameron Leffler. And Arnold's free throw is up and good. First points of the night for Corbin. So Corbin will have one more. Nice way for these Longhorn seniors to be able to go out here as that free throw is no good. 1 of 2 for Arnold. That is Hamilton. He'll go to Fabrizio. Fabrizio back to Hamilton. Now to left. Over to Fabrizio. He'll go back to Leffler. Leffler will go to Fabrizio. We're down to 30 seconds, and Chris Pass will foul Jackson Fabrizio. It'll be the first foul on Pass. That'll put Fabrizio to the line. He just come in off the bench and will attempt his first free throw. It is up and good for the junior Jackson Fabrizio. He is ready for one more. And it is also good. For 2 for 2 for Fabrizio. Extends the lead 57-36. Oldroyd will bring it across. He'll fire up a shot wildly. No good. Fight for the rebound. And it's going to come down to Peterson. Peterson will go to Leffler. And Leffler will look to Fabrizio. Fabrizio will kick it out to Peterson. Now back to Fabrizio. We're under 10 seconds to go. And Fabrizio will go to Hamilton. Hamilton will hold, and that will do it. Your final score is going to be Tabiona 57 and the Longhorns 36. This game was actually a lot closer in the first half, as I believe it was a 4-point lead is all it was for the Tigers, but they come out in the second half and did just the things that Coach Giles said he wanted them to do in his keys for the games. He wanted them to attack the rim, and they did. He wanted them to rebound. They did a great job on the board, especially the offensive boards in the second half, and then make shots, and they shot a much better percentage here in the second half than they did in the first half. with this victory, it'll put Tabiona in first place all by themselves at 7-0. They're guaranteed at least a share of first place as they will travel to Rich next Friday. And the winner of that game, if Tabiona wins that game, they will win the region championship outright. If Rich comes away with a victory, they will tie Tabiona, and then I don't know if they do a coin toss, if they have a playoff game, or what they will do for first place. I'm not sure what the region rules stipulate there. As far as the Longhorns, they will now have a record of 1-6, and they will travel to Manila. Manila is winless in region play so far. The Longhorns beat Manila their first time, so we'll see if the Longhorns are able to go to Manila and get a victory there. They will claim fourth place here in the region, and if they are unable, if they lose to Manila, then there'll be a tie for fourth place, and I believe there will then be a play-in game between those two, as far as I understand how the region works for that fourth place game. So the Longhorns come up short here on senior night as Tabiona has a big second half, led in the second half by Dusty Jones and also Dylan Leffler. They were the two big scorers for the Tigers in the second half. Justin Clyde really did a nice job of keeping in the first half for Tabiona as he scored, looks like 10 of his 12 points were scored there in the first half for Justin Clyde. So we appreciate all you watching and all the many sponsors of high school sports. Again, we'd like to thank the high school administration, the coaching staff, and their coordination in helping this make this coverage possible. DVD and Blu-ray copies of tonight's games are available. Go to VTV Channel 6 or call 781-1902 for your copy. Again, this is Merlin Rasmussen signing off for VTV Channel 6.